everyone. I'm just starting off by saying we just finished a Zoom class with Jim at Family Martial Arts, and it was awesome. Jim, Dom, and Ashley were all there, their family. And it was great. It was really good. Great to see everybody live and not talking to a phone that doesn't respond back. So that was pretty great. It was like human interaction almost. So that was a great class, and I can't wait till we do a few more of those. I might switch it up and try to do something like that for us. Zoom, I don't have an account, so a paid account, so it's just a little too short for me. So I might try to do a house party thing one of these days. Anyway, so my shout out today goes to Jim for putting that together, and to Dom and to Ashley. So all three of you, thank you so much for doing that. It was great, and I got a little sweaty. So I figured while the momentum's up, I might as well get started. So we are doing another cardio kickboxing class today, and you'll need everything. You'll need a mat. We will need a mat a little bit here and there. If you have an elevated surface, we would love you to use that. If not, offer modifications. If you have bag and weights, obviously, use those. If not, and you have light weights, let's use those. You can air punch. You don't need to have gloves or a bag. You can definitely do it without. We'll be doing a lot of arm work today as well, so you'll need lights, or mediums and heavies. And I think that's it. So around, there's four sections today, or four series in this. There are 12 exercises in each. The timing is 30 seconds on, 10 seconds off. During your 10 seconds off, it is totally up to you today whether you take your break or you just want to move on to the next thing right away. Some people like to keep going, some need a rest. It's totally up to you today. And there are four of those, 30 tens. I think that's all I have to say. I do not own rights to the music. I don't think yesterday's video posted onto YouTube, so I'll get that uploaded onto my fitness page today due to music violations. Unfortunately, I screwed up on that one song. So I think I went through the list and we should be okay today, and we will get started. Enough of my talking. Come on. All right, so we're gonna start off today. We're gonna get some of this out of my way. We're just gonna punch it out.
We go boogie, oogie, oogie, jiggle, we go dance like a rope on fire. We go drink some, take shots until we fall out.
We're gonna keep it on this side. Give me the block.
Nigga, take off all your clothes and light the roof on fire.
Forward and back.
Fire it all.
up, taking it back. Six. Nine and 10. Front only. Two different, one on each side. And we start with jab, cross, hook. So we're one, two, three. Jab, cross, hook. Then we switch and do the other side. Then we are doing, this one's kind of weird. A knee and a knee. So you're going to like pretend that you've got a bag or a person's head and you're going to knee, 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 knee. So it's all ab work here, with your weights in your hands as you're doing it, or your gloves on. And then the next one is a squat and a punch alternating, okay? Then we're grabbing, oh, we're going for cardio. We shuffle, shuffle, top jump. If you're not jumping, you're giving me knees. We go to curls, half curls, lower weights, horizontal curls. Then if you have a bench or something elevated, we're doing reverse lunge each side. Then we're coming down for side planks, so we hold stillness. There'll be other side planks, so we'll have movement in those. So hold stillness for this first round. If you do not have a step or any elevated surface, you're just giving me reverse lunges on one side, then reverse lunges on the other. If you prefer forward lunges, go right ahead and do them. But I just want you to concentrate on one side and then come and do the second side so you burn out a leg. Again, this is 30 seconds with a 10 second rest. I know, a little longer than the five, but that's okay. What did I say was first? Jab, cross, hook. So you can go right into the other side and not take your 10 second break. It's totally up to you today. It's not a Tabata class where I'm killing you for 20 seconds and forcing you to take a rest, or a HIIT class where I force those. So the reason is that you're allowed to take, that you don't have to take your breaks this time, is because I'm not pushing you to the limit during the working segments. So there is a method to it. It's not me just making fun of you for wanting to keep going or taking too many breaks. There's a reason, the way that the classes are designed, I swear. So I know, I have no idea about time, but I guess it was a couple weeks ago. when I start at my shout outs. Keep it up. All right, we're doing those knees now. So one of my shout outs was to my friend Mary, who has this a little boutique, another one of her shirts. Mary, Urban Princess. So knee, knee. So you're coming down, coming down. It's weird to do it without a bag, I understand. So this is the best I can do. Get those knees up, man. You're really crunching those abs in here. One more. All right, front punch. We're gonna squat and punch, just a straight punch, alternating sides. So get into that squat, punch, squat, punch. Love Gaga. You guys know that. Going into some cardio. We're gonna shuffle, shuffle, tuck, jump. So clear some space for yourself. Shuffle, shuffle, jump. Only 30 seconds. Then we're picking up our heavy weights after this and going right into bicep curls. Keep it up. Elbows are glued in. You're doing a full extension here. You come all the way down and bring them halfway up. All right, if you are switching to lighter weights, you're doing that now. Arms will be straight out, palms facing up. Curl it in. We have reverse lunges after this. Remember, your arms stay parallel. Straight out from your shoulders here. You should look like the letter T. Okay, so if you have an elevated surface, get a leg on it, do a reverse lunge. We're just gonna pulse on one side. If you do not have an elevated surface, I want you to just give me reverse lunges on one leg. We're switching legs after this, and then we're down for a 30-second side plank on each side. Holding stillness in your side planks today. All right, take your break. Switch legs. And go. All front leg that is actually doing the lunge here, all the weight should be in your heel. You should be able to lift your toes. You don't want that knee to protrude over your front toe, so make sure you're in good alignment here. You have 3 seconds. All right, we are down for a side plank. I'm using my mat for my feet so they don't slide. Get down, get up to a side plank, don't wait for me. I'm just maneuvering things in my house. Okay. Arm can be up, arm can be down, I don't care. As long as you're in a side plank, you can be on your elbow. You can have a knee on the ground. You can take whatever variation you want. I just want you to hold stillness this round. There will be side plank movements coming up after this. Future rounds. All right, switch it to the other side. You can switch right over and get right into it. You can take your break, you can readjust. All right, again, arm can be up. Down. Make sure those hips are up. You're not sagging down here. Hips are up. You're in a perfect line from shoulder to toe. Your wrist is right underneath that shoulder. All right. You survived round one. Round two is coming. Take a break, grab a drink. We are doing jab, cross, hook, upper. 1, 2, 3, 4. Or 1, 2, 3, 5, I believe. Each side. Then we're doing an elbow, a squat, and 4 high knees. We'll switch to left leg back after that. Your cardio is a forward side jack. So you're here, here. If you are not doing the jacks, you are stepping out. Grabbing your weights, overhead triceps, switch it back to kickbacks. Then we hold one weight, the heaviest one you have, and we get a little pulses, okay? Toe taps. So again, if you have an elevated surface, you're doing toe taps. If you do not, you're giving me little front kicks, okay? Plank ups. I would like to do them on the bench, but I don't think that's going to work too well on my elbows because of the surface. You can put a towel or something down. And the point of this is to do plank ups here on an elevated surface. If you can, if not, do them on the ground. Side planks again. This time we're doing dips. So when you're down there, you're here or here, and you're dipping. So we got the movement in there this time. They are your moves. Each side.
Starting session.
All right, get those little weights, or your gloves, or whatever it is you have, and we're doing the jab, cross, hook, upper. Right leg back, go. I am not doing a good job of protecting my face. I'm realizing that as I'm going through this. So hand should be up, cross, hook, upper. Switch legs. I told you, I screw up all the time. My instructors are always telling me to get my hands up. So get them up. Jab, cross, hook, upper. Itch. We have that elbow and high knees thing coming up. Okay. So we are right leg back. You're elbowing, you're squatting. Give me 4 high knees. There you go. Elbow, squat, One, two, three, four. Leg back, elbow, squat. Taking breaks. Hands up and go. Elbow. Remember that you want that power with your hip and your elbow. All right, front side jacks. Pull up your pants. She's so annoying. And it's not like they're getting too big on me. My weight has stayed within 2 pounds during the whole quarantine. So 2 to 3 pounds, I guess. And then pulses. So you try to get them to touch your back almost. Okay, you get them that low. And then really work that tricep to pull it up. Do not strain your neck here. You're working your triceps, not your neck. They can be nice and slow. You should feel that right here. Down. You're going for kickbacks next. Finish. It's a hair. Always a hair. All right, kickbacks. So you're here. You're not rocking them. You are in complete control. Nice and slow. Squeeze. Squeeze the tricep at the top every time. You are looking at the floor in front of you. If you need to look off to the side, that's fine. Do not look this way. You're just hurting your neck. One weight. Get it down behind you. You are right here, holding onto both hands on the side, and you're pulsing from the side. You can see I am not touching my butt. No butt touching this class, just saying. You are pulsing nice and tight here. Your arms are straight. You can feel it in your triceps. I can. We have toe taps next. Turn this around to the right side. You're not doing toe taps. You're giving me little front kicks. Focusing on your abs. It's a little cardio, and it is working your abs here too. You're staying, keeping your upper body super still, sucking your core in, hitting those knees up. If you have a Bosu ball or something, you can tap all around it, get some movement. Next are plank ups. I'm gonna try them on the bench, show you what I'm talking about here. I just need a padded surface. So they're a little easier this way than on the ground because you're bringing the floor up to you. You can do this on the wall. You can do this on the floor. Try to switch arms, your leading arms here. two. Side plank dips. I'm gonna do them, I think on my elbow this time. And we're dipping. Your hand can be on your hip. It can be straight up in the air. Your feet can be staggered like mine. They can be on top of each other. You can have a knee down and do your dips this way. They're a little easier, but if you have any lower back concerns or elbow issues, it's a good alternative. Other side. Last one in this round. We're more than halfway done class, that means take the warm up into consideration. We have two more to do. You got it, come on, almost there. Good job. All right, up next, we have a jab, an elbow, and a kick. Once again, like every class, you have the option of a front kick or a roundhouse. Totally up to you. Your next one's a jab, jab, each side. Your cardio is hacky sacks. If you're not doing the jump, you are touching those toes. You're crunching those abs, you're twisting those obliques, you're getting all the benefits from it without the cardio. We're doing a squat with an overhead press every time. Then we're doing a squat with an upright row. Then we're just doing rows. There are your three weighted moves. If you have a bench, I need you to step up, knee up, and give me a twist. You twist in the direction of the knee that's up. So step up, knee up, twist it over. You can have a weight in your hand for that. If you do not have, this might be too, I think I have to do the littler side. Yeah, like that was too high for me. So if you don't have a surface that's elevated, I want you to squat, knee up, twist. One side, then the other. So there's your alternative. Then we are down for a bridge. So we're just holding the bridge for 30 seconds. Then we're doing a push-up into a bird dog. So all your push-ups will be on your knees. You do a regular push-up. You come up, you extend opposite leg, opposite arm. Another push-up, extend the other side. So that's why these are meant to be on your knees. You can still actually, you can do them on your toes and do a bird dog, which is a lot harder. But if you want to challenge yourself, you can do it. Do your push-up and come out this way. Up to you. I will be on my knees. All right, grab a quick drink. Get set up. Jab, elbow, kick. Hands up. Jab, elbow, kick. Pull it back. Got this, guys. Okay, other side. Brakes are up to you. Three, two, go. Bounce is really off on that one. Again, you can do a roundhouse kick or a front kick. We do have roundhouse kicks coming up. Man, not balanced. There's more wine in my system than there is water, so my hydration is pretty off right now. Oops, that was an elbow. All right, jab, jab, right leg back, Very simple move. Jab, jab. Just burn out one arm and burn out the other. Remember to keep that other hand by your face and guard. It is a gorgeous day. It appears to be a gorgeous day out there. I haven't opened the door to see what the temperature is, but I think today's going to be the day I'm finally going to go for a walk. I'm staying this for a month. Left leg back. I have a happy hour at 4 o'clock, so I'm going to try to get out there and get a little more exercise today. Remember to breathe, inhale, exhale. Weight is in your heels. All right, we're doing a squat with an upright row. So go a little wider here. Have enough room for your weight between your legs. Squat it down, row it up. This is your shoulder and leg portion, ladies and gentlemen. Try not to hit yourself in the face like I keep doing. Bent over rows. 5 seconds, or you can be going. Grow it up. Squeeze that back. As soon as you get that row up, squeeze and release. Squeeze and release. You are looking at the floor in front of you. You're not looking straight ahead at the camera at this point. I demonstrated what we were doing. There's no reason to look at me right now. Okay. Now we're doing a step up, knee up twist, or you're doing a squat with a twist. Keep it up. We're switching sides and doing the same thing on the other leg. Get right into it if you want. You can take that break. You're down for a bridge after this. Almost there. There we go. Down for a bridge first. Get on your back. Feet as close in as possible. Up in a bridge. You are in one straight line from your knees to your shoulders. You're squeezing your abs. You're squeezing your glutes. Your legs should be parallel to each other. Nothing splayed out to the side, not too far in. Take some breaths here. It's a nice calm moment. All right, flipping it over. We have a push up into a bird dog. Again, I will be on my knees. So get your hands where it's comfortable to let them go, to not have to readjust. Opposite. You get to stretch out your abs here and get that great extension. Ooh, balance. Okay. Next set, we're flying right through this. This is your last 12 moves. We have high-low kicks. So I want you to try to kick normal and then get it high. Normal, higher. Both sides, it's gonna be a burner. Then we are high, low, jab, cross punch, each side. Your cardio are skaters. You don't know what skaters are. Your alternative for skaters is just to step it out without the cardio, okay? Then we are doing, with our medium weights, front side alternates. You can take both of those weights, just one or heavier one, whatever you want, and we do wood chops next, each side. Then using a bench again, I want us to pretend it's the floor and do burpees off of the bench. So I'll turn them around this way. So your burpees will start here. So you're not gonna be down on the ground, unless you really wanna be. I'm just making your burpees a little easier today. And then we're doing mountain climbers, same thing here. Again, for these should be a much easier version of burpees for you, but if you don't have an elevated surface, do burpees on the ground. If you do not wanna do the full burpees, you do the little jump at the end. Mountain climbers, same thing. You can utilize a bench, you can do them on the floor, you can do them standing, you can do them against the wall. And then your final one is a spider leg lift. We've done this plenty of times. One leg, you come out of the plank, because you're lifting this up and squeezing your butt. You come right back down into a plank every time, okay? And then we will switch legs and do the other side. And then we're done. Done is good. All right, so grab those light weights. Even though we're kicking, I still want the resistance in your hands, and you're up, guarding your face. I'm gonna start with my left leg just because it sucks. So I don't care what leg is back first. I just know that my left leg is not as good at kicking as my right, so I'm just gonna get it out of the way. Try to go high and low. Ooh. I know we always start with the, but we do start with the right leg back, so that was actually great. The difference is crazy from one side of my body to the other when it comes to kicking. I guess I should really practice that, huh? As you can see, I'm not very good at the kicking portion of kickboxing. Ooh, one more. All right, high, low, jab, punch. Oh my God, am I already on cooldown music? low, jab, cross punch. Was that my man's papers? Oh, I'm gonna have to run out and pay them. Okay. Yes, I'm super excited. Didn't know when they were coming. Left leg back. Sorry for the noise. Landscapers are here. Right now it's the little things. My neighbor had just texted me this week and asked when the guy does both of our lawns. So, you heard? I'm like, no. It rained all week anyway. Okay. Cardio skaters. Up to you. Front side raises. You're not touching your legs, remember. Up, and you just come right by them. Yes, we are ending with a bit of cardio at the end of this one today. I like to end with cardio some days. I'm taking the heavy weights, do my wood chops. You can do it with or without weights, it's up to you. So I'm starting here, bringing it down, up. Feel that in your abs. This is an ab exercise, guys. You're working those obliques here, plus you're getting some extra arm work in. Okay, other side. Again, you can go right into it or take the break. I feel like I need the break today. Remember to breathe. I have back-to-back killer songs on this one. I think I said that last time too. All right, burpees on your elevated surface if you have it. If not, burpees on the ground or the jump on the top. I feel like I need to do them back here though, so I have a little bit more room. So sorry that you have to stare at the back of me. But I need this to be against a wall, so it doesn't move on me. That's what I'm trying to say. Mountain climbers, same thing. Elevated surface if you have it. If not, on the ground, on the wall, standing up. Your choice. Go. Try it those knees in. All abs here. All right, we have spider plank leg lifts. Last one. Get it. Get that leg in into a plank. Up into a three-legged down dog. Crunch that oblique. Crunch it in. Get that knee to the elbow. If you want to take a little child's pose, stretch out your back. This is your last move and we're done. Get it up. Crunch it in. Squeeze that glute. Got this, guys. This is it. Last one. Oh, good job. All right, it's time to stretch.
Stopping session.
Grab a little drink. I think we're is that about 45 minutes? I don't know if I did. I don't think I quite went the hour today. All right, if those legs wide, let's take a deep breath in first. And let it down. Those legs wide, hands flat on the floor if you can. Walk it over to one side, grab an ankle. Take it into a side lunge. Turn and take it into a runner's lunge. Without falling over. Take your hand on the inside of your foot, twist up, and let's walk it over to the other side. Grab that ankle, just let it stretch out your hamstring here, and bring it down into a side lunge to stretch out the inside of your thighs here. Turn to a runner's lunge. Hand down, twist the opposite side up. And walk it back over to the middle again. Walk those legs in. Roll it up. Roll those shoulders back and forward. Clasp those hands out in front. Round your upper back. Overhead. And stretch it over. Overhead. Stretch it over. Bring them behind you. And give your back a nice stretch, as well as your chest here. All right. Hands on hips, let's roll that head. And the other way. All right, we're gonna breathe it out. Completely empty out your lungs here, just let it all go. Inhale. And exhale. One more, just fill those lungs all the way up. And let it out. And we are done, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you very much once again for tuning in. I loved seeing so many of your faces earlier today, so hopefully I'll, I haven't been very good with scheduling. I just kind of do it when I feel like it. So I'm going to try to do a live class, maybe one night this week. So I will be in touch. We're probably gonna do house party, just because it's free. and I think I can have up to 8 people on it in a live session, so I'm going to check into that. Thanks for the tips on that today, Monica. So I'll look into that and maybe put something out that we can do something later on. One night, we'll do it at nighttime, since I know a lot of you are still working during the day. Or maybe we'll do something tomorrow, I don't know. I'll just put it out there. So again, thank you for coming. Try to go outside today and enjoy the beautiful weather. At least I think it is, it looks it. And have a great rest of your weekend, and I'll see you guys tomorrow.